In this video, you're going to learn how to debug in Flutter Flow. This video is brought to you by No Code MBA. If you like the instructor in this video, Flutter Flow expert Doc Williams, check the link in our description to get his full No Code MBA course teaching how to build in Flutter Flow for beginners. Okay, let's get into the video.
If we look at this little bug right here at the top, it's going to give us an error if we have something going on with our application. Right here, there's no errors detected. In the previous video, we showed how we had to set up our database. But let's go through another error that can happen or look at what it looks like. So in this way, we're going to click the submit button. We're on the new task. So this is the page where we're creating a new task and then it's adding it to our database. We're going to click the button. We're going to go and open up the action flow editor. Now here, this also gives us a preview if there's any errors with what we're dealing with. Now, we already have three actions already created, but say for instance, we're creating a fourth. So I'm going to click add an action. And this time I'm going to click Firebase. Oh, look, even before I click anything, you see how it turned red right here. Now it mentions action configuration, action not defined. So it's already giving me an error because I haven't done something. So what's the action I want to do? I'm going to say navigate to new task, right? And so now I have it in green of what it's now expressing, okay, what I've done, I've declared something, it's going in the right direction, there's not going to be an error, and now I can continue. Now I can edit that action, I can do different things, I can like say, for instance, let's just give it a whole nother action, let's do fire. Let's do read a document. Now you see where it says read a document. It says Firestore update reference for database read document action not properly set for the button. So now it's prompting me to continue to make the changes. And that's what's really great about Flutter Flow. It's going to show us how to debug and show us exactly where to go. If I want to add notes, this is great. If I'm going to declare a certain action and I want to add to my documentation, I can add that for myself or, you know, someone if I'm tell it all those things. So let's go out for a second. Let's make this smaller so I can see everything. I'm going to delete this action and now it's green again. It's green. So I'm going to close this. So that's showing us how we can debug the application. If it's in red, if it's in a real error, it won't let us go into test mode anymore. We have to solve it before anything happens. Before I'm adding a lot of things to my project too, it's important. I think I've mentioned in other lessons, I would just save the version. If this is green and I haven't, you know, I don't have any errors, I might save it to that point and before I start creating or adding new actions or changing some things up, because then I can always revert back to an action that I know is clean. That way I don't keep messing things up and I have a problem. The second thing is if we debug, there's going to be the difference between errors and then warnings. Now, warnings might be things nice to have, things to consider, but we don't necessarily have to do it. But it allows us to really do more thinking to make sure we have all of our ducks in a row as we're launching our app. But again, errors, we need to really have a clean slate. The warnings will just be a nice to have if we need to consider it or something like that. So right here, it says Firestore security rules may be too open. Maybe. Click here to view the rules. You can suppress this warning by unchecking has private data for affected collection. So right here, if I click into it, it's going to take me here. Okay. And now I can start looking at the rules and see if I need to change something, right? That's just something to keep in mind if we're going to be doing something. Now, again, depending on what it's asking us to do, we can do it, but it's just giving us a warning. We may need to do this. So it says you can surpass this warning by unchecking has private data for affected collection. So we can go into a little bit deeper, look at what we need to do and go from there. So that's how you can be debugging and looking at the warnings and things like that. Now, how can we preview it? Well, if you're clicking that lightning right there, that lightning icon, it will allow us to see the test session. Now, as we do that, it will allow us to have a test mode And the session will be probably less than a half an hour. And we see right here, the test session expires in 7 minutes. Then we'd have to redo it again. But once we have the test mode, we can see our application. We can say instant reload here. Thinking about its life, it's going to reload. And we see that the current load is going to expire in 7 minutes. And then we're able to do this, right? We're able to see our application and then go from here. I also like right here, it shows troubleshooting info. And then it says known issues right here. This is really good because maybe there'll just be a couple things that something's not right or something's going on. We can now review what's going on with the team, what's going on with the platform, and just things to consider, what kind of browser we're using and all of those different things. And then afterwards, we can end session. That is a preview how you can not only debug, but also preview your application. We'll see you in the next video.
Thanks again for watching. If you want more FlutterFlow educational content, check out the link in the description to go to our full FlutterFlow for Beginners course on No Code MBA. And when you sign up for the course, you'll also get access to all of No Code MBA's content in one membership, which covers building apps with AI and Bubble, building in Airtable, building in Glide, and much more. So I hope that you enjoyed the video. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get all of our future free content here on YouTube, and leave a comment if you have any questions. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.